Hello, my name is Dragon Edge and welcome to the 5th episode of Galidia! In today's episode, we need to secure the place. Because the village had already had one or more raiders inside. We lost a couple of villagers and I still can't find Jack. I found Rose. Rose is in this building. But Jack is gone. Is just gone. So I hope we'll find them. Jack and the other villagers. But what I said, we're about to secure this place. But first, if you like my videos, please like, subscribe and hit the notification bell. It would really help me out. Hopefully in the next episode I might have some answers. Thank you! Today I start with a town gate and I'm not going to make the complete wall because it is already a very long video. I wanted to show you a little bit of grinding as well, but unfortunately I've grinded for like 3 hours this time and it was just too long for the video. So I start with the gate only. The town gate, if I start with the town gate, I really start with the opening in it, just to look how to build it, how big it needs to be. And as you see, it needs to be a little bit bigger than just a castle gate, because more things need to enter. It is a town, it is bigger. So unfortunately we are in survival, and if I make the town gate too big, we need to make everything bigger, like the church and other builds, and I didn't want to do that. So it is still pretty small. It could be a little bit bigger. If I was a creative, I would have made it a little bit bigger, but I would have made everything bigger. You see, I'm a little bit measuring also with towers as well, because I didn't want to make too big towers, so I needed to do a little bit of an oval in this build. Same counts for this, the second tower. The same count for the second tower. Unfortunately, it needs to be a little bit, it is not a square as I would have wanted it. You can see I try to look from as many angles as possible so that I can see where I made my mistakes, and better than before I go on with the build. Because if you're building and just go on and go on, you will miss the mistakes and you see them after you're too far, and I didn't want that. So that's why I look from different angles throughout the whole time. Second time already, group of these pillagers came by. So what am I doing with them? Well, obviously I can't win against them. I mean, I'm not armed at all. So what I need to do is just let them pass and try to lure them away from the village. Quite often if you die in Minecraft, it is because of something stupid. Whoa! Unfortunate events. I can go on building. I started above the gate now and I needed to have a little bit of an overhang because there is a bridge here. There comes a bridge here and the enemy will be close to this part of the castle. So I need to reach it if it's close to the wall, and that's why I put some holes in the ground where you can shoot through. Many castles and many things like this were made of wood, and that's why there are not so many castles anymore. They tried to whitewash it so you wouldn't see it as wood, and it would be better for if the castle got burned down, it wouldn't burn as fast as wood. Here I got killed. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and dead. Yeah, I died a couple of times this episode, and I didn't like that, but unfortunately I couldn't do anything about it. It was very hard. I have the difficulty on hard mode, and you can see that. Here we have the beams. Once again, I like to make it a little bit realistic, so a little bit more support, and I wanted to show the support. You can see I didn't make an overhang for the towers because they are bordering water or closer to water, and the enemy can't get close to it that easy, so they won't. Because if an enemy needs to come close to your build before they can start doing something, it is very dangerous for them. I mean, I can prepare for war in a castle, they can't. So that's why they wouldn't dare to come close if they can't reach it very easily. And that's why a gatehouse is the most dangerous part of a castle during siege. A gatehouse is basically a large hole in your wall, and an army needs a large hole to get in very easily. So even if they come over the wall, they will quite often just use that to open the gate and let in the whole army. With this tower, I tried to make it a little bit of a realistic tower. I wanted it to have a very steep part at the top, and a little less steep at the bottom. That is pretty realistic, because having a high roof will make it very a very heavy roof, and you don't want to support all of it at once. So many times a roof of a tower had two parts: a very steep part, which is very heavy, and a little less steep part, as you see with this tower. But still, we're in Minecraft, and in Minecraft not everything is realistic. You're building with blocks of half a meter, which is a little bit more than the usual brick we use in real life. So sometimes you need to have a little bit of variation, and that's why I built the other tower, this tower, with a little bit of an overhang. So it would just give a little bit more of the depth I like in a build. A lot of the things that I know about castles actually come from a YouTube channel called Shadowversity, which I like to watch a lot. So if you want to know more about castles, I mean, I am not going to tell everything he told, because it has been told already once. So I put a link of his channel in the description, and I hope you are going to watch it. If you like castles just like me, you can learn a lot from him. He talks about every type of castle way more specific than I could, and a lot of the things I do in Minecraft I only do because he said it's realistic, and I try it out, and sometimes it works out beautifully in Minecraft. So please look up his channel here in the description. And this it is, the end result. This is going to be the gate of this town. And as you see, there is a small part of the bridge already, but that's only the wooden part, because I want a stone bridge here. You will be able to get rid of the wooden part once there is a seat or something like that. I will show you a little bit of the inside. If I had enough iron now, I would not have taken the same doors in the backside. I would just have put some iron bars down here. And maybe in the future I will do that, but now this was a simple and good solution. Here we have a couple of shooting holes. And here is the overhang. As you can see, maybe I don't have my bow and arrow, but I can shoot straight through it, and I can even shoot at that wooden plate down there, so I can take down a lot of enemies from here. Here we have the other part. In a real castle, this would have been supported a little bit more. Maybe I will still do that in the future. Once more. And this is the end of the episode. I hope you liked it. And if you did, like this video, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. That would really help me out. Thank you for watching. This was Dragon Edge.